All right. What's up? What's good? What's going on? Welcome to the War Zone once again. Here we are, people, with UFC 270. So what we're going to do, man, is give some brief breakdowns and some predictions on these fights. We're going to start with the early prelims and work our way all the way up to the main card. So without further ado, let's get into it. First up, in the women's flyweight division, we have Kay Hansen against Jasmine Jasutavicius. So, Kay Hansen, older fighter, not too impressed with her fighting style. So I'm going to have to take Jasmine Jasutavicius in this one. She beat Pilastri rather handily. She's definitely had a longer camp. She has time to train. She has great ground control, great takedowns, taller fighter. She has a 5-inch height and a 5-inch reach advantage. And I just believe she'll get it done. Like I said, she's a better grappler. She's definitely a better striker. So I got Jasmine Jasutavicius in this one in a unanimous decision. All right, so next up in the men's lightweight division, we have Matt Frivola against Genaro Valdez. I'm going to take Genaro Valdez in this one. He's an undefeated fighter. I love his aggression, his grappling, and his striking. I think he's going to definitely win this fight. I think Frivola has become chinny. He's had some decent close decision wins in his career. He has been KO'd. I just don't think his chin is going to hold up against a fighter like Genaro Valdez, and Valdez grappling is just leagues above Frivola. So and his striking as well. So I'm gonna take Genaro Valdez. I'm gonna call a third round TKO in this fight. All right, next up in the women's strawweight division, we have Gomez Juarez against Vanessa Demopoulos. So, I'm going to have to go with Vanessa Demopoulos. She's fought the better competition. She's the better striker. However, Gomez Juarez is definitely the taller fighter. She has a 6-inch reach advantage in this fight. She's 1-inch taller. However, I just didn't like her performance, her last performance against Godinez, man. She got subbed in the first round by armbar. I just think Demopoulos is she's a veteran, and she's gonna find a way to get this fight, win this fight. So I'm gonna call a decision by Demopoulos, 29-28. All right, next up in the men's bantamweight division, we have Tony Gravely against Oliveira. So Simon Oliveira, man, I don't quite know why he's actually signed to the UFC. Very middle of the road fighter. Tony Gravely has definitely fought the better competition. He's a high level grappler. I trust he will win this fight convincingly. And I think that this fight will end in a TKO. And I think Tony Gravely is going to come back with a vengeance in this fight. And I think he'll get it done via ground and pound in the second round. So I have Tony Gravely by TKO in the second round. All right, next up, we have men's welterweight division. We got Jack Della Maddalena against Pete Rodriguez. I am going to have to go with... I'm going to have to go with Della Maddalena in this one, man. This guy had an 0-2 start, and he's been on a 10-fight win streak. He's really grown into his craft here. This guy's got knockout power. He can sub you. He has great cardio. Pete Rodriguez. I like Pete Rodriguez. He can take you down. He can fight on the inside. Very dangerous. I just don't think he's ready for Della Maddalena in this fight. And plus, he's taking this fight on a short notice. So I'm gonna have to go with a decision win by Jack Della Maddalena. All right, next up, men's welterweight division. We have Morales against Giles. So Michael Morales and Trevin Giles. I'm gonna have to take Mike Morales in this fight, man. Michael Morales is a standout, amazing prospect, man. This guy is undefeated. He's 12-0. He's great stand-up, great grappling, great kicks. He can finish you at any point in the fight. Great takedown defense. I don't see Trevin Giles trying to take this fight to the ground. I think he's gonna stand, but Morales is too well rounded. He adds more to his game than Trevin Giles. Trevin Giles is basically a boxer. He is dangerous. He can strike, but like I said, he's not gonna grapple, and he's taking this fight on short notice as well. So I'm going to take Morales to pull this fight out. I give Trevin Giles a close round in there, but this could be a unanimous decision. But I'm going to say decision win by Morales, 29-28. All right, next up in men's bantamweight division, we have Ronnie Barcelos against Victor Henry. Wow, I'm going to have to go with Ronnie Barcelos to pull this fight out. Really, really good fighter in Ronnie Barcelos, man. I think his career is really delayed. And I think right now he's got some things to prove. Very, very tough fighter, man. Very, very tough fighter. I think Henry has had a longer camp this time. Solid fighter. To me, he's 34 years old. He's more of I think they utilizing him more as a gatekeeper to gauge the experience of certain fighters. But I expect Ronnie Barcelos to dominate this fight and win this fight via unanimous decision. Victor Henry's never been stopped, but you know what? This may be that time. But unanimous decision, Ronnie Barcelos. All right, next up, men's featherweight division. We have Ilia Topuria against Charles Jourdain. I'm going to go with Ilia Topuria. Unanimously in this one, man. He's my biggest favorite of the night. Very, very skilled fighter, man. Grappling. This guy is undefeated. He has very, very, very devastating body shots. He's just a better overall fighter than Charles Jourdain. Jourdain can scrap. But Topuria's skill level is just too much, way too high for him. So I expect this fight to go no longer than two rounds, so I'm predicting that Ilia Topuria will finish this fight in the second round via TKO. All right, next up in the men's middleweight division, we have Rodolfo Vieira against Wellington Turman. I'm going to have to go with Rodolfo Vieira, man. Stronger, better grappler, definitely a submission threat, better stand-up. His stand-up has definitely progressed from what it used to be, and I trust his sub game in this fight. Wellington Turman, not impressed with his fights at all. I think the Sam Alvey win was his best win. Very chinny guy. So I'm going to trust Rodolfo Vieira to get this fight done via submission in the third round. So there you have it. Rodolfo Vieira, third round submission. All right, next up in the men's bantamweight division, we have Cody Stallman against Saeed Nurmagomedov. I am hands down going to have to go with Saeed Nurmagomedov in this one. Better grappler, great kicks, great footwork. Takedown defense is awesome. Great cardio. I think Cody Stallman, this is towards the end of his career, man. I'm not sure what he has left in the tank, how much he really wants it. I think he's one of those guys that's here for a check as well. So I'm taking Nurmagomedov to win a decision in this one. 29-28, Saeed Nurmagomedov. Next up in the men's welterweight division, we have Michael Pereira against Andre Fialho. I'm going to take Michael Pereira to get this one done. Very explosive, great footwork. This guy has flying knees, Superman punches, awkward style. He uses the ring very well. I think it's just going to be too much for Fialho. But Fialho is a solid fighter. He's fought decent opposition. However, he's coming in on short notice as well. I just think Pereira just has a rhythm in that ring, man. It takes a special fighter to actually figure him out. And I think by the time Fialho does, if he does figure him out, it'd be a little too late, man. So I got Michael Pereira by decision, 29-28. All right, next up, this is the men's flyweight division. This is a title fight. This is a trilogy fight between Brandon Moreno and Davison Figueiredo. So Brandon Moreno is the champion. Very good champion, man. This guy has got heart galore. His cardio is out of this world. Like I said, that's the best thing. He's just solid everywhere, man. Striking, on the ground. This guy is coming to defend his title, man. Trust and believe. Now, Davison Figueiredo, the former champion. Yo, man, this guy right here, man, this is a do or die fight for him, man. I believe this will be his last shot at reclaiming the title. And I expect the very best version of Figueiredo. He definitely wants his title back, man. This guy is he's good as well. Now he's given up a size advantage to Brandon Moreno, but he has shown that he can stand in there and bang with the best of them, man. I'm going to go out on a limb, man, and say that Davison Figueiredo, man, gets his title back. I think he finds a way to win this fight and reclaim his title. So that's how I have it. I have Davison Figueiredo winning a close split decision in this one. All right. Here we are, people, with the main event of the evening. We have the men's heavyweight championship of the world. We have the champion in Francis Ngannou, and we have the challenger in Ciryl Gane. Now, okay, so let me break this down real quick. When we talk about Francis Ngannou, we talk about power, power, power. Francis Ngannou is going to have to find a way to close the distance in this fight. And this guy's hands are lightning fast, man. If you go and look at some footage on Francis Ngannou, man, the power and the speed of his hands is just incredible. He's a lot faster than people actually think. He has been working on his takedown defense. He's shown that in the last fight against Stipe Miocic. He stuffed some takedowns and actually took the back of Stipe Miocic in that fight, and went on later on to finish him. Now, Ciryl Gane, just skill, and more skills. This guy moves like any other heavyweight I've ever seen in UFC history. I mean, the footwork of this guy is just phenomenal. And I expect him to be on his bicycle in this fight. This guy can take you down. He has a great jab, and he definitely knows how to utilize the ring. He's got leg kicks. Just overall, skill-wise, he's just a better-rounded fighter than Francis Ngannou. But Francis Ngannou has a great equalizer. So, wow, people, this is a 50-50 fight. I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, I wouldn't be mad at you if you took either fighter. I'm kind of feeling like Francis Ngannou at some point is going to have to actually go at Ciryl Gane. But if I'm looking at the styles of both of these fighters, I'm going to have to go with Ciryl Gane to pull this one out, man, in a decision win. I think he wins three rounds to two. Just because of his skill. And his and the fact that he's just better overall, and he utilizes his kick so much. However, if he does try to take Francis Ngannou down, and Francis Ngannou is successful at stuffing some takedowns, I think this is going to be a long night for Ciryl Gane. But I'm going to take Ciryl Gane by decision. I think he wins three rounds to two. But people, like I said, I wouldn't be surprised if Francis Ngannou ends this fight at some point. So there you have it. I appreciate you all for tuning in. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Please hit